An ovulation chart is an important tool to use to understand your monthly cycle.
This will help you make sure you know when to try to conceive.
You can find a variety of charts online or in stores, but they are actually pretty easy to create on your own.
We can help you make your own in the comfort of your own home.
First of all, if you want to get pregnant, it is important to know your body.
The average monthly cycle for women lasts 28 days.
This means she will start her period on day 1, usually ovulate on day 14 and be ready to start a whole new cycle on day 1 again.
A normal cycle length can be anywhere between 23 days to 35.
As a rule of thumb, most women will ovulate 14 days before her next menstrual cycle.
Since I have a longer cycle, usually lasting between 33-35 days, I will ovulate later, between days 19-21.
The egg only survives 12 to 21 hours after it has been released from the ovary.
Sperm can live in a woman's body up to 2 to 3 days.
To be able to track your most fertile days, it is essential to have an ovulation chart.
It is really easy to make ovulation charts.
If you only want to keep track of your monthly cycle and are extremely regular, you are more than welcome to just use a calendar.
If you want to create a graph-like chart, you may want a piece of graph paper to help you make columns.
You will first want to make a column for the days that you have your menstrual cycle.
Day 1 will be the day you start bleeding. The last day of your cycle is the day before you start bleeding again.
Next, you will use the lines going horizontally to track your basal temperature.
You may want to purchase a basal thermometer to do this. Make sure you are checking your temperature before you get out of bed.
This is your ultimate resting temperature.
At the bottom of your chart, you should also create horizontal lines to track cervical mucus.
Right before your period, you will normally have some light discharge.
Just right before ovulation, your cervical mucus will thin.
You may also want to keep track of how you are feeling, such as breast tenderness, mood swings, restlessness, etc.
It is also important to keep track of emotions you are feeling because that could alter your cycle length.
For example, if I have a bout of depression, my cycle usually lasts 35 days instead of 33.
By pulling in all these methods of determining ovulation through an ovulation chart, you will be able to figure out what days are the most fertile for you.
Hopefully, you can use this tool to help you achieve your goals.